Meet Chewbacca, towering Wookiee, co-pilot of the Millennium Falcon, and fashionably challenged with extra-long pants. Turns out, Peter Mayhew, the man behind the Wookiee, wasn't just tall because of some galactic magic. He had Marfan Syndrome. So while Chewie may have had trouble finding pants in his size, it wasn't the Wookiee genes to blame. But enough from me, I'll let the galaxy's tallest co-pilot dive into the rest.
Marfan Syndrome is a disorder that affects the connective tissue in many parts of the body. Connective tissue provides strength and flexibility to structures such as bones, ligaments, muscles, blood vessels, and heart valves. When you have Marfan Syndrome, there's a defect in the gene that encodes the structure of fibrillin and the elastic fibers, a major component of connective tissue. This gene is called fibrillin-1, or FBN1. In most cases, Marfan Syndrome is inherited. The pattern is called autosomal dominant, meaning it occurs equally in men and women, and can be inherited from just one parent with Marfan Syndrome. People who have Marfan Syndrome have a 50% chance of passing along the disorder to each of their children, and in 25% of cases, a new gene defect occurs due to an unknown cause. It is also a variable expression disorder because not everyone with Marfan Syndrome has the same symptoms, and the symptoms may be worse in some people than others. Marfan Syndrome is present at birth, however you may not be diagnosed until you're a teen or a young adult. Marfan Syndrome prevents connective tissue from growing and developing normally. This makes the tissue in your aorta and heart valves become weak and inelastic. A lack of elasticity can cause your aorta to widen and bulge. It can also result in your heart valves not opening and closing properly. What is the aorta? Your aorta is the largest artery in your body. It carries blood and oxygen from your heart to other parts of your body. It's shaped like a curved candy cane. And your ascending aorta leads up from your heart, while your descending aorta travels back down to your belly. Now let's dive into aortic dilation and aneurysms. You're probably wondering what that is. Well, an aortic aneurysm develops when there is a weakness in the wall of your aorta. The pressure of blood pumping through the artery causes a balloon-like bulge in the weak area of your aorta called the aortic aneurysm. This bulge can cause your aorta to widen, which is called aortic dilation. It can also affect your heart valves, which are flaps that separate into four chambers of your heart and keep blood flowing in the right direction. An aneurysm in the aortic root part of your ascending aorta, the section closest to your heart, is specific to Marfan syndrome. A growing aortic aneurysm can also lead to a tear in your artery wall. A dissection allows blood to leak in between arterial walls. This causes the narrowing of your artery. If an aortic aneurysm ruptures, it causes internal bleeding. And depending on the location of the aneurysm, a rupture can be very dangerous, even life-threatening. But with immediate treatment, many people can recover from a ruptured aneurysm. Now let's talk about another complication of Marfan syndrome, mitral valve prolapse. But before we do that, let's go through some of the anatomy involved with this condition. Your mitral valve is the door that connects your left atrium with your left ventricle. These are two chambers of your heart responsible for collecting oxygen-rich blood from your lungs and then pumping it out to your body. Your mitral valve is made up of two strong flaps of tissue called leaflets or cusps. These leaflets open and shut with each heartbeat to manage heart blood flow out of your left atrium and into your left ventricle. Mitral valve prolapse, or MVP, is a condition in which your mitral valve flops back into your left atrium. That's why it's sometimes called floppy valve syndrome. This floppiness may prevent your valve from closing as tightly as it should. MVP is often harmless and doesn't cause symptoms for most people, but some people with moderate or severe prolapse have symptoms and may need treatment. The main complication of MVP is mitral regurgitation. This means blood leaks the wrong way through your valve. If the leak is severe enough, you may need surgery or a procedure to help your valve work as it should. As we wrap up, remember that managing Marfan syndrome doesn't mean the adventure stops. I mean, I wasn't just a co-pilot, but a warrior. Individuals with Marfan syndrome can live full, exciting lives by staying on top of their health. Whether through lifestyle changes, medications, or even surgeries, there are ways to keep the heart strong. So just like the Wookiee who stood tall, those with Marfan can continue to stand strong and face their own challenges head on.